Hey Fierce Babes, welcome back to my channel. It's a girl Boss Babe, Mimi, back with another video. And as you may know, I did a video about 10 steps you need to do to start a business, something like that. If you haven't, go ahead and check that video out, okay? It's basically telling you the steps you need to start a business. Now, this video is about things you'll need to start a lip gloss business. Yes, a lot of females out here nowadays are having a little lip gloss business, and there's some that actually wanna start one but just don't know where to go, what to do, anything. So I'm here to give you guys the information. So if you haven't already, please like, comment, and subscribe to my YouTube channel. And on this video, tell me what you thought about it. And let's get right into the video, guys. So I do have a lip gloss business, and if you haven't already, go ahead and check it out. I sell lip gloss, mink lashes, matte eyeliner pencils, lip liner pencils. What else I sell? Lip oils. And I am also working on a skincare line. So I'm very excited about that, guys. So if you haven't already, please check out my website. It's www.fiercelybeautifulcosmetics.com. I'll leave the link below so you can go ahead and support your girl. I would really appreciate that. So yeah, I run a lip gloss business, and I recently started the end of May. And so far, so good. You know, you just really need to be consistent. I know you guys hear that word a lot, but that word means so much, because that's how you're gonna get your business out there. And everybody's hungry, everybody's promoting themselves. I know sometimes you'll feel discouraged, or you just don't feel like you're getting anywhere. Just don't give up, okay? These are for the people that do have their business already, and these are the people that want to start their business, okay? Do not give up. So, I'm a small business. I'm not even out there yet, but trust me, I promote, I put myself out there. You're gonna see these posts. You know what I mean? So yeah, do not give up. All right, so the first thing you would need is ingredients, right? So if you wanna start this lip gloss business, you're going to need Versa gel. That is like the main ingredient that goes into lip gloss. And then also you're gonna need mica powders. You can purchase this anywhere, like TKB, Amazon, the list goes on. So you're gonna need Versagel, you're gonna need makeup powders, you're gonna need your oils. There's so much oils to choose from, okay? Coconut, castor oil, almond oil, grapeseed oil, vitamin E oil, you know. But just keep in mind, if you're using almond oil, be mindful for the people that are allergic to peanuts, or put that in your ingredients on your website, on your products, whatever, so people can know, okay? Also, what else you're gonna need? You're gonna need scents and flavoring, you know, to give your lip gloss some really good flavoring. And I will leave the items that I purchase, like for anything that I'm mentioning in this video, is going to be down below so you guys can know where I purchased them, okay? So that's it for the ingredients, just stuff to put in the lip gloss. The next thing you're going to need is a website or a platform, some type of place where you can promote your business, okay? There's so much to choose from. I talked about this in my previous video. There's Shopify, you can use GoDaddy, Wix. It's a lot. It's a lot. Etsy, Amazon, and just so much more. you're gonna need a platform to promote your business and to you know, just promote your items that you're selling. The next thing you're gonna need is tubes or containers, meaning lip gloss tubes, squeeze tubes, whatever you want to put your lip gloss in. You're gonna need those. Very important, you know, so you can purchase these many places. Okay, there's also TKB, there's Amazon, there's DHgate, there's AliExpress, there's Alibaba, there's other people that are selling lip glosses. You can purchase it from them, you know what I mean? It's just so much places. All you gotta do is go on Google and type in empty lip gloss tubes, and then boom, it will literally just pop up. Okay, so make sure you have your containers to put in your lip glosses. Make sure you have your containers to put the lip glosses in. There you go. The next thing you're gonna need is labels and packaging. Okay, so now that you got your bomb name, once again, I spoke about this, you're gonna need a bomb name. You're gonna need a logo, right? Once you got your bomb name and your logo, you're gonna wanna kind of like, I don't know, you could do it by yourself. Avery.com, onlinelabels.com, sticker.com. Even people could do it for you, or you can do it yourself. You can use these apps like Canva, PicArt, Fonto, things like that. You can create a logo so you can print it yourself, okay? But me, for my labels, I use Avery.com to print. But I did create my logo by myself, but I did use Avery.com to print. It's just much easier and the quality is better. That's what I think. But yeah, you're gonna need packaging. Also, branding. Branding is very important, like brand yourself. So if you know you wanna stick to red and black, get red and black packaging. Branding is very important. Like if you know you got your colors, let's say gold and black, make sure everything that you're using as packaging, whether it's the lip gloss boxes, it's the bubble mailers, it's the little gift bag thingies, the organized bags, I don't know their names, but those, make sure everything looks good, you know what I mean? So that's very important. And plus it makes your products look more classy, like more classier and more better. So yeah, back to the bubble mailers. You're gonna need bubble mailers, and you're also going to need some type of box, especially if you're doing wholesale. If you think about doing wholesale, me, I'm not there yet, so, but I will get there in the name of Jesus. Okay, but if you're doing wholesale, most definitely you're gonna need boxes. Okay, so make sure you get you some boxes and some bubble mailers, because if you're shipping from your home, those are very important, okay? You're going to need a printer and or a label printer, okay? But most definitely a printer, because that's how you're going to print your stuff, your labels, and anything else, you know what I mean? So you need a printer, okay? I purchased my printer from Walmart.com. It was actually on sale, so I really got lucky. But you can buy HP, Canon, you know, just so much good brands. Make sure you get an all-in-one printer, so you know, it's just better for you, you know what I mean? Faxing, scanner, printing labels, whatever. Also, the label printer is for, like, that's the thermal printer that doesn't require ink. So a lot of people use those. I actually purchased one of that too. But to be honest with you, I haven't used it yet because I don't know how to install it. Very sad. It's very, very complicated, but I'm going to get it. But if you would like, I'm going to leave that also in the link so you can purchase it if you would like. The next thing you're going to need is a weighing scale. This is very important because this is how you're going to weigh your products or your objects. That's when they're in a bubble mailer or even in the boxes, you have to mail them. So you can purchase a scale at Walmart, Amazon, wherever they sell scales. Yeah. I got mine from Amazon. I'm also going to leave that below so you guys can know. So yes, you're going to need a weighing scale. Very, very important, especially if you're shipping from home. The next thing you're going to need is printing paper. Very important. This is to print the packaging slips, the shipping labels, stuff like that. I got mine from Walmart.com. It's just plain white paper, good firm white paper. But you can purchase your paper anywhere, guys. Anywhere. It doesn't matter. Okay? The next item you're going to need is a ring light. This is super, super important. Like, you need a ring light in your life. Okay? It's kind of pricey. Invest in it. It's going to do your pictures so much justice, you know? I got my ring light at Amazon. At the time, it was like $40, but it's not the big standing tall one. It's like the short one that you could put on a table, whatever. But just invest in one, guys, because your pictures will look twice as better, trust me. That's very important, especially if you're taking the pictures by yourself. So invest in a ring light. Another thing you're gonna need is organizer bins. Yeah, those are very important. Reason being is because you're gonna want to organize your stuff, okay? Because you're just not gonna throw your lip gloss and your powders and your oils everywhere. No, you're gonna wanna put it in bins so when you open your stuff, everything is organized. And it's also just look better, more sanitary, you know what I mean? You can get bins from Walmart, Amazon, Kmart. Where else? I mean, just Google it. Organizing bins or organizer bins. You know what I mean? And yeah, make sure you purchase one. It's super important. This is how you're going to organize all your products, okay? The next thing you're going to need is optional, but very helpful. You're going to need like some type of background. I don't know if you guys know like those little white furs that you put your products on, or some people use construction paper, some people use some type of silk material. You're gonna need some type of thing so you can put your pictures on there, your products on there so they can look nice, you know what I mean? So me, I'm using the white fur. To me, that's just like a nice, clean look. But creative. There you go. Just be creative and make sure when you put your products on that background that you use and you put that ring light on it, it look good. You know what I mean? Quality is important. And this is what customers look for, the quality of the picture, okay? Make sure your quality is bomb.com. All right, next step. So this is gonna be the last thing that you'll need, all right? And it's going to be business cards and thank you cards. Super important, okay? You wanna put those in your packaging to thank the customer, and also for the business cards. So, you know, if they ever lose your website, they have a business card. I know it's very old fashioned, but trust me, it's very helpful because that business card have all your information. You know what I mean? If you have a store or if it's a website or email, phone number, whatever, it's on that business card. And also when you go to the store, you can pass them out if you would like. Hey, you know what you want to do with them business cards, but it's very important to have. And the thank you cards as well. You know what I mean? You also want to thank the customer for purchasing from you. All right? So make sure you have those as well. And you can also create these at Avery. Not Avery. Those free apps I was talking about. Canva, PixArt, Fonto. There's a website called Zazzle. Z-A-Z-Z-L-E, Zazzle. Where else? I'm just gonna leave them down below. Right now, my mind isn't working. You know what I mean? So, I'm gonna leave them down below for you guys. All right, so guys, this was the end of this video. Thank you so much for watching. If this information was helpful, please let me know down below. If you haven't already, please like, comment, subscribe to my YouTube channel. And, you know, just tell me what you guys thought. I would really appreciate it. And, you know, a word of advice. If you want to start this business, start it. Don't give up, okay? Don't get discouraged. Manifest the life you want. Bring those dreams to reality, okay? So, there's nobody stopping you but you, okay? So, thank you so much for watching. Until next time, guys. Bye. Keep showing up, and I'm gonna keep showing up.